our partnership with the Cedar Center fits within goal one of our strategic plan focused on implementing high expectations for each student. More specifically, a strategy within that on ensuring that each student benefits from college and career-ready expectations with a focus on strengthening supports for students with disabilities and English learners. We recognize, however, that this work cannot be undertaken alone and closely intersects other areas of our strategic plan. Goal three on teacher workforce, given the principal's role in strengthening supports for teachers across general and special education to best serve students with disabilities. And then goal four in particular, focused on strengthening supports for school leaders. So we work to intentionally connect this great partnership with the Cedar Center across the council and with goal four in particular, focused on school leader support. With goal one, really focused on ensuring each student has benefits from college and career ready expectations and has access to the high expectations and appropriate services and supports that he or she needs to be successful in school and prepared for a life of lifelong learning and success in the world more broadly. The professional standards for educational leaders are really foundational to our work broadly in strengthening supports for states to strengthen supports for school leaders. And our inclusive principal leadership work in partnership with CEDAR is grounded in and builds from the PSEL standards. In 2015, we worked collaboratively with the National Policy Board for Educational Administration, or NPBEA, to update the professional standards for educational leaders. And these standards refreshed the Interstate School Leaders Licensure Consortium Standards, or ISLIC, and emphasized really the principal's role as building manager, but also as instructional leader, really putting a finer point and emphasis on the principal's role as instructional leader and building the capacity of instructional and non-instructional support staff to strengthen outcomes for each and every child. We know effective principals are particularly important for the success of students with disabilities. And when principals create safe, supportive learning environments, students with disabilities and other students who may struggle to learn in school are really able to thrive. And so we worked in partnership with CEDAR to extend the standards to the context of strengthening supports for students with disabilities.
As a follow-up to the Professional Educational Leadership Standards, CCSSO and CEDAR worked together to create this document that you see on the screen here, which is really designed to help states consider what are the actions that can be taken to ensure that principals are both prepared and supported to establish and maintain inclusive classrooms and buildings. And this document was created through a group of practitioners. There were many principals at the LEA level. There were state education agency representatives, as well as representatives from higher education, as well as associations that helped in the development of this. And what you'll see in this document is taking those standards that were designed through the PSEL work and really bringing them into the lens of how do you establish an environment that is inclusive of students with disabilities where they can thrive. And some really key action steps are highlighted within the document. And what's so great about it is it's not a separate document, but really aligned to the original PSEL standards that were developed. And I think it has real potential to help states really think through an aligned approach in the way in which principals are prepared. As a result of this document, CEDAR, as well as CCSSO and the Center for Great Teachers and Leaders, wanted to pull together a group of practitioners and experts in the field that are really involved in the space of preparing and supporting leaders, both at the SEA, the district level, and even within the educator preparation programs, recognizing that principals are called upon to do a number of things, have a number of initiatives that they're charged with, as well as a number of individuals that they're supporting within their buildings. And wanted to bring together both the TA providers, technical assistance providers that were across the country that had some role in supporting leaders, as well as national associations. There were 32 individuals there representing across of TA centers and national associations. And what was really great about this was an opportunity to come together and really think through, all right, now that this document has highlighted the actions that can be taken to help principals run and establish inclusive buildings, what can we do to align our work so that way we don't feel like we're pulling principals in 101 different directions? How does this work situate itself within the existing technical assistance that's going on in states?
a variety of national advocacy organizations, representatives from various federally funded technical assistance centers, researchers, members of educator preparation across traditional and alternative prep, as well as practitioners themselves, came together over the just critical role that principals play in creating or cultivating equitable learning opportunities for each and every child, with a focus on students with disabilities. And collectively, the group really didn't want to stop at the release of the document and a single meeting. So committed together to collaborate over the course of 1 year and work together to release the supplementary guide supporting inclusive schools for the success of each child, a guide for states on principal leadership, which is an online microsite that provides 8 strategies and accompanying resources to support states in integrating inclusive principal leadership in policy and practice, building upon many of the recommendations in the foundational resource, the PSEL 2015, and promoting principal leadership for the success of students with disabilities. The link to the site is up on the screen. The URL is ccsso inclusiveprinciplesguide.org. We'll spend the next portion of today's webinar highlighting some aspects of that online guide. These organizations partnered over the past year and really provided their time, resources, and collective expertise to come together around the 8 strategies identified in the guide, pulled their resources from their respective organizations that were aligned to that foundational PSEL document, and really want to just acknowledge the tremendous collaboration, time, and commitment of those 20 organizations. The 8 strategies up on the screen were identified by the National Collaborative on Inclusive Principal Leadership and represent really the collective knowledge base of leaders across the field. So those with content expertise and strengthening supports for school leaders, as well as outcomes for students with disabilities, and articulate how to ensure and best support principals in their initial preparation and ongoing support of professional learning to lead effective inclusive learning environments for each and every child with a focus on students with disabilities. Strategy 1, setting a vision and plan for inclusive principal leadership. 2, cultivating coherence and collaboration, recognizing that this work cannot be done alone, but must be done in partnership of the state education agency, from talent or educator effectiveness to special education, as well as school improvement, and in partnership with key stakeholders outside the SEA, institutions of higher education and ed prep program providers, as well as districts and schools. Strategy 3, transforming principal preparation and licensure, which is a focus of our partnership with the CEDAR Center and the CEDAR Center's work. Strategy 4, promoting principal development on inclusive practices. Strategy 5, providing targeted supports to districts and schools. 6, connecting school improvement and principal development initiatives. We're hearing from many of our state members as they are working to best support those schools identified for targeted support and improvement and comprehensive support and improvement. But inclusive principal leadership is one strategy that could be helpful in best supporting those districts and schools. Strategy 7, which connects to 2 on meaningfully engaging stakeholders as partners in the work. And strategy 8, last but not least, adopting processes and supports for continuous improvement. So monitoring existing investments related to school leader development. Today, we'll focus on strategy 3 on principal preparation.
In this resource, there are the strategies that Kaylin just outlined, but there's also action steps that can be taken. And here's just a number of those relative to principal preparation and licensure. How do we ensure that there's some level of expectations for principals that are aligned across the career continuum, starting with preparation? And of course, with anything, taking a look at your assessments, whether they be performance assessments or other kind of assessments in terms of licensure, to ensure that the competencies and the skill sets that are highlighted within this document are reflected within those assessments. So that way, when a candidate does exit a leader preparation program, you have a level of confidence that they have been supported to learn those skill sets as they went through the program. And there's also a huge part across the country where preparation programs, leadership preparation programs in particular, are revising their programs, are reconsidering and reforming their programs to ensure that the content that's highlighted within this document are fully integrated within the coursework and the field experiences that the leaders are required to participate in as part of their leadership. I think this is critically important, whether you're going through a formal traditional leadership program or whether your state has engaged in leadership academies as per ESSA. This is an excellent opportunity to take a look at the content and the experiences that through the research, through practitioners, through a lot of voices, really demonstrate that this is what a leader needs in order to establish an inclusive environment and culture within their buildings. And then, of course, there's accreditation requirements. You can take a look at their accreditation requirements and see, are there requirements that allude to these inclusive leadership practices that are within this document? So there are some strategies that are pretty specific here. There's a list of questions that you can ask yourself, which I think are very powerful because it comes from many different roles. So if I'm an educator preparation faculty member, or I'm a leader faculty member, or if I'm a state education agency that happens to be in charge of certification and licensure, or if I'm a local district, or perhaps I'm involved in the state and leadership is not my expertise, but I'm focused on school improvement, or perhaps I'm focused on educator talent and managing educator talent. All of those things come into play when it comes to the way in which leaders are supported and how to establish this kind of environment within the schools. So there's some probes there, I think, that are very powerful that help a reader identify what role that they might play to create this aligned system. These strategies also lead you then to a cadre of resources. These resources are resources that are representative of the 20 organizations and associations that were part of this group, and it also extends outside of that. One of which is the innovation configurations that come out of CEDAR. And this is an excellent resource to really help universities, educator leadership preparation programs, whether they're traditional, non-traditional, whether they're leadership academies. It's a great resource to take a look at what is the research, what's the evidence base behind what a leader needs to know and be able to do to support inclusive buildings, and really allow some probes and some reflection if I'm a faculty member or in charge of a program to see, do we have these within our preparation programs? Can we link to these within our coursework and field experiences? And it identifies some gaps and some strengths that a program might have and leads you to some action planning relative to that. Also on the top, you see a CEDAR course enhancement module, and these also are very valuable. So if I'm a faculty member or a professional development provider supporting leaders in any way, shape, or form, this course enhancement module really is ready-made professional development learning activities that can happen for leaders that really align with the innovation configuration and the contents of the document and the resources. Below those, you see promises to keep, which really highlights what both teachers and leaders need to know and be able to do, most particularly in establishing multi-tiered systems of support and really thinking through how to support students with disabilities. And then lastly, thinking about principal preparation programs. As you can see, you're looking across the career continuum here to ensure that there's some consistency in expectation for these principals when walking through. So these resources are just among many resources within this site that can help articulate the vision and the action planning for states.
So in terms of where we're going next with the inclusive principal leadership work, we are very much committed to providing short and longer term support to states through our partnership with CEDAR and the Oak Foundation, focused on developing school principals who are well prepared and supported to lead effective inclusive learning environments that meet the needs of students with disabilities and indeed all learners, as best leadership practices for students with disabilities are really best practices for each and every child. Grounded in the microsite as well as the PSEL foundational resource, that supplementary guidance document. We want to support states in building upon, deepening, and refining current work on school leadership to have a greater focus on inclusive leadership practices, recognizing that states already have a lot of great work underway on school leadership and improvement, and want to provide supports to states that really meet them where they're at in building upon and refining that work.
So the Oregon context is that we have 7 universities, 2 public and 5 private universities that prepare principal leaders as well as district leaders in our 2-tier license system. And it includes the Oregon Principals Association state level group that is responsible not only for professional development for existing administrators, but they also have a preparation program that they conduct in cooperation with Concordia of Chicago. Oregon Professors of Educational Administration is a state affiliate of the International Council of Professors of Educational Leadership. And as a result of that state affiliate, we have connections nationally to this conversation around inclusive principal preparation, but also a seat at the policy table here in Oregon. And with that, then, that gives us a chance to really focus on refreshing rules around principal preparation. PSEL has been out since 2015, but the NELP standards were just officially adopted by CAPE in August of 2018. So I think we're actually able to strengthen the crosswalk between PSEL and the National Educator Leadership Preparation standards that are there now officially adopted. So we did join together teacher prep and principal prep to focus on two things. We wanted to focus on the clinical practice. So what are practitioners getting while they're doing their preparation program for the principalship that's really focused on leading inclusive schools, leading instructional practices that provide opportunities of support for each and every student? So with that, we had a chance with the CEDAR funding to develop new modules, the CEMs that are listed in our references at the end of this presentation. And we've been developing new modules for our preliminary administrator license program. And then this past month, we were officially awarded additional monies that are available through CEDAR 2.0. And what we want to do with that infusion of some funds to support this work of the modules is to embed these modules throughout all of our leader preparation programs through the Oregon Professors of Educational Administration. And then we have also developed a proposal that was accepted to work interstate partnerships as well. So other state affiliates within ICPEL have been doing this important work of inclusive principal practice and preparation. So Georgia, Ohio, Arkansas, a number of states that are state affiliates with ICPEL, we have built into our CEDAR 2.0 work to partner across state lines and not just within the state of Oregon. So the Oregon plan was to develop these modules in summer of 2017 at three institutions, Portland State University, George Fox University, and the University of Oregon, and use them as early adopters into this work and inform the rest of our higher ed institutions within the two foundational CEDAR tools that course enhancement modules and the innovation configuration models were used extensively as we created the modules that we rolled out in principal preparation programs in 2017 and 18. The way that we chose to focus this work is in the area of behavior, intervention, and discipline, concepts of FAPE and other things that are very well known to us in preparation programs and state level work, but not as familiar to people who transition necessarily from teaching roles into leading roles. Portland State and George Fox really focused on those two aspects of federal legislation, Oregon policy, not just in the context of policy, but actually into practice. And so those modules that PSU and George Fox developed were on behavior and discipline, where University of Oregon really focused on networking and transitioning, that idea of least restrictive environment as it carries over into community colleges, into institutions of higher ed, and transitioning network to inform new school leaders. And then our plan for 2018-19 is to really look at ways to implement this in our district level leadership preparation. We've been informed recently with the work of Tom Bellamy and others in the state of Washington around licensure preparation for the role of people leading special education initiatives at the district level. That work that he had really done through the University of Washington was focused on high needs area of replacing special ed directors that are retiring in states of Oregon, states of Washington, and other states with the information they need to be really successful directors of special ed for LEAs.